Okay. Get some more wood brought over here. Right now, though, I'm basically burning a lot of my scrap lumber too. Trying to get rid of this. You probably can't hear me saying much over the compressor, but I mean, turn the camera off and I'll bring it back whenever I get this hot enough. Okay, what I did while y'all were gone, I've been heating it up. It takes a little while sometimes once you get it hot. Nope. Okay, what I'm gonna do now is take this file and get my final shape on all of these edges. Get this straight, odd, perfect, and straight. You can probably see how easy the file is cutting this. But there's also some hard spots in it too. There's some soft spots in it, and there's some hard spots. That's going to be the next step, to fix that. There's a little bit of a bend in it. We're going to get that bend out, too. So, stay with me. Okay, what I'm doing here now is I got the fire going. Fixing to go for the clinch. Now I'm going to show you something about that that will blow your mind. Okay, what I'm fixing to do now.
I'm going to do a water clinch.
I'm protected by the agent. A lot of people just never learn. But it works. It's hard to do an adjustment.
Next thing I done was I found this piece of an old pipe, and it'll go on the end of the handle like this for a booster. Well, anytime you do these burn through handles and this type handle, and you have a tang like that, you've got to have a booster or it's going to start breaking out on you, cracking out. It's just not going to last as long. You got to have something to support it. And so I just took the cutting wheel and I lined it out around it, and I'll work that down. Probably I just work that down with my pocket knife where I can slip that on, and then I'll hammer it all on tight. And so that's where I'm at so far on this.